Welcome back to the WAG Q&A video series. Today we're talking all about calories and the things that you want to know about them. Not all calories are created equal, and that's what we're talking about today. When you're thinking about your calorie consumption and your calorie expenditure, we're not thinking about it in terms of the day-to-day or the things that you're doing each day. We're looking at trends over time. So you're operating under a surplus, a deficit, or at maintenance over time, not necessarily in every single day. Your weight's gonna fluctuate. So maybe you wrote an extra 100 calories today, but then if you eat that extra 100 calories tomorrow, then you know you didn't row that extra 100 calories. So it doesn't necessarily help you keep things consistent to monitor change over time. So what you wanna do is keep your calorie intake consistent, depending on, you know, maybe you might be eating more on training days, less on rest days, but you don't want to compensate calories for exercise for a couple reasons. One, you could start developing a relationship with food in terms of feeling like you need to earn your calories. So I need to row 200 calories in order to be able to eat this scoop of ice cream that I'm going to have later. That's something we definitely want to avoid. But also, we want to make sure that we can monitor what changes need to be made to your nutrition over time. So if over the week you lost an average 1 pound or 2 pounds, then you can add in if that's a little bit too fast. Or if you weren't losing any weight at all, then you know that you might want to take some calories away. But looking at it from day to day, workout to workout, is definitely not the best approach. Some days are just going to be more active than others. Just like I answered in the last question, it's best to keep things consistent so that you can see what changes are happening over time. So if you're having a really extra active day one day, but you don't have different calories for training days and off days, it's best to just stick to the plan and try and make sure that that day, if you're a little bit extra hungry, eat things that are higher in volume. We don't want to get into the relationship of, oh, I did so much extra work, so I get to earn more calories, and that might make you overtrain or overexpend yourself over the next couple days. All calories are definitely not created equal. You're getting your calories from multiple different places. You're gonna get calories from carbohydrates, which is 4 calories per gram, protein, 4 calories per gram, fat, 9 calories per gram, and alcohol, it's in its own category, which is 7 calories per gram, but we're not gonna be talking about that. We do have a Q&A episode all about alcohol though, so check that out. But calories coming from carbohydrates, protein, or fat are going to be doing different things in your body, and your body needs them for different reasons. So protein, for the maintenance and building of muscle mass in your body. That's the building blocks of your muscles. So that's going to be doing something different than the calories coming from carbohydrates. The calories coming from carbohydrates are generally going to be their most preferred fuel source for your body. It helps you feel fresh, helps you feel ready to go. And fat is going to be good for hormones, for brain function, also a little bit for energy. They're doing different things. So the calories, although they might be the same amount of calories, it's definitely not going to be equal in your body. It's worth mentioning that calories coming from high quality sources and calories coming from processed sources are also not going to be equal. So even though they might be the same amount of calories, it's not going to be equal. So let me use the example of carbohydrates. You could get carbohydrates from refined sugar, or you could get carbohydrates from fruit or from whole grains. Those calories are going to not necessarily be created equal. For instance, when you're eating carbohydrates coming from fruit, you're going to be getting a lot more fiber, or any fiber at all in there, as compared to getting calories or carbohydrates from refined sugar. It's also going to be processed by your body a little bit differently, as the fruit comes in something called a fruit matrix. It's got lots of micronutrients in there, and it's going to be processed just a little bit differently. So calories are definitely not created equal. Calories, although delicious, are a little bit more complex than you think. So it's really good to use this information to help you decide what kinds of food choices that you're going to make. Calories also can impact your body weight, which is what we're going to be talking about next week. Don't forget to tune in.